Hello, welcome to another tutorial. This one is about Grackle, a Google Suite accessibility tool. If you are on a Baker College computer, this tool has already been loaded for you. If you are using your personal computer, go to Add-ons, Get Add-ons, and you would search for Grackle Docs. This is it here. And install. There are Grackle add-ons for docs, sheets, and slides. This platform is an accessibility tool that will allow you to ensure your documents are in ADA compliance for use with screen readers. I'm going to show you how to use the tool with a Google Doc. You can see the doc pulled up on the screen. Go to your toolbar and access Add-ons, locate Grackle Docs, and launch it. It will take a few moments for the accessibility check to run, and you will see the results to the right. Anything with a red X is showing straight up errors that you need to fix in order to make it accessible. Anything with a green check mark means it is fine and has passed the checker. Anything with a green check mark and a red exclamation point, these are warnings and worth looking at and fixing. The nice thing about Grackle is you can click on these items to get details of how to make your corrections. When you make corrections, you can click on Recheck to see the results, as Grackle will update the accessibility report. So I'm going to start working on these items. First, under the document, we can see we have one issue. Document title is required, so basically we need a heading. Now, sometimes, although it passed in this particular case, sometimes you will also have to specify the language, which would be English, but in this case, we have already passed it. But if not, if this was a red X, you would just click on it and set language and then choose EN, which is the abbreviation for English. But we're good here. So you have some choices here. It's kind of telling you that you need to have a document title, or essentially a heading 1 is where you're going to put this together. But a document title is what you need to have, and you can use this document title up here by just clicking the Use the Google Doc name, or you can actually hit Edit and give the document a title and say Update. And then we can recheck. And now we can see that this top area of the document, the document title is required. That now has a green check mark. Got the green check mark here. We're good. Images are all set. You may, if you do have a logo or you have a picture, a photo, a graph, a chart, sometimes this will show up as not passing the accessibility check, and then you'll have to go in and add alt tags to those images. And again, the Google Grackle tool will walk you through doing that. So we're talking about headings. We have some of those issues here. Again, we have warnings, and they're telling you that you should have a heading. As we know, if we've done this before in Microsoft Word, using the heading format of heading 1, heading 2, heading 3 just makes it easier for a screen reader, because maybe a person does not want to read every aspect or every part of the particular document. Someone with a screen reader then can use the tab key and advance to the next section. But if you don't use headings, all of the sentences and all the words are just going to run together. So it's identifying that this is something that we can do. So please use a heading style or mark paragraphs as a heading. A single heading one should be used, and headings must be properly nested. What that means is that you have one heading one, and then as you drill down into the document to use additional headings, you'll use heading twos, potentially heading threes, heading fours. You want to follow that proper nesting. You don't want to have a 1, 2, and a 4 without having a 3 somewhere in the document. So let's go ahead and correct the headings in this document. I'm going to highlight the AG256-Veterinary Science and go into Format, and then into paragraph styles. You'll see we have choices here. We have normal text, title, subtitle, heading 1, 2, 3, and so forth. So I'm going to identify this as my heading 1. And so I can use the shortcut key or just click, and now I have my heading. Now, if you need to adjust this to a different font size, you can do that as well. And then we're going to move down to the next one, Big Ideas Establish Goals. Oops, format. Paragraph styles, I'm going to call this a heading 2. And, oops. I'm going to decrease that font size so that it's smaller than my heading 1. And again, and let's say I'm going to make this one a heading 3. And maybe I'll make this tentative calendar also a heading 3. Okay, so let's do a recheck here and see if we've addressed our headings. You'll see the percentage of the document here as it's working its way to 100%. 21 out of 22 checks have passed, and I already know what the other one is. You may have well also, because we see that we have an issue with tables, and here's our table right down here. So you have to properly lay out tables as well. So we'll work on that. So some things to consider for tables. Tables should be tagged or marked as layout tables. The use of merge cells is not recommended. The use of empty cells is not recommended. As it relates to content, high color contrast should be used. Fine print, in other words, font that is too small, should be avoided. Lengthy paragraphs should be avoided. And for links, they should be informative, so don't use click here. Have the name of the website that you're going to launch. So let's go ahead and get started here. So I can, again, go to tables where I have the red X, and I can click on this, and I can see I don't have any merged cell issues here. The use of empty cells is not recommended. Again, there might not be anything I can do about it in certain situations, or I may want to do something about it and put something in there. You just have to kind of see what your specific situation is. So we're at this particular point, and what we want to do here is to start inserting our tags. So this works like an image where we're putting alt text, alternative tags on the image so that the screen reader will be able to identify and describe what's here for someone who has a visual impairment. It's going to do the same thing for tables. So I'm going to double click on the tag, and this is basically showing us how we are to tag this per table. We're going to need to have a header row and a header column as well. And so we will use this area in order to make that happen. So I'm going to use mark first row as a header. So then I'm going to update, and I'm going to recheck. This will just take a moment. Okay, so we have 22 of 22 checks pass. Now this particular table is a little different. Sometimes you'll have a heading here or a tag, and other times you'll also have one down this side, and then you'll have content in the middle. Now I happen to know some other things with this particular table is that I think the size of the text in the table at 10 is maybe a little small. So I could go ahead and adjust that if I want. Again, these are recommendations at this particular point for size of fonts. I usually like 11 and higher. I don't like going any lower than that. And then you also have to kind of take a look at from a color perspective, is there anything there that we need to be concerned with or worried about? High color contrast should be used. We don't really have any complaints here. The checker did not pick anything out. But if you had, you know, maybe some pale yellow and then another kind of a yellow, light yellow, maybe there was not enough differentiation. So that would be difficult from a color contrast point of view. You want stuff that definitely looks different. So we have white text or a white space, black text, kind of like a light blue gray here. And so there's enough differentiation. But you could adjust the font size, you could adjust the color, any of that kind of stuff. And then when you're done, you can go up and hit recheck. To the side of any of these areas, if you get the green check mark, you know that everything is good, everything is passed. You have some other items here that you might want to take a look at. Empty cells have been detected. Remember, again, that's a warning and it says it's not recommended. Maybe there's something you can do about it, but maybe that's just the way it has to be. But they're telling you that empty cells should be avoided for the most part. And again, too, if so, let's say there was one and you thought you could fix it and it was this one right here, you could just click on it. It would take you right to that spot in the document. Headers and footers should be used. Again, these are warnings. They're not anything specifically that you have to do, but it might be something to consider. And you may want to make some of these changes. Adjusted alignments. Bring everything to the center of the page, what have you, with those blank spaces. So again, this is using Grackle, which is a built-in tool, a built-in add-on for the Google Suite platform. It works for docs, slides, and sheets, and it allows you to run accessibility checkers similar to what you would use in the Microsoft Office Suite, but this works for the Google Suite platform. Hopefully this was helpful to you. There will be more coming down the road from a tutorial perspective with other aspects of using these accessibility tools.